Hey friends, welcome to the YouTube channel All About Electronics. So in this video, we will learn about the common gate amplifier configuration of the MOSFET. So in case of the common gate amplifier, typically the gate terminal is at AC ground. So here, the input is applied between the source and the ground terminal, while the output is measured between the drain and the ground terminal. And since the gate terminal is at AC ground, so we can say that the input is applied between the source and the gate terminal, while the output is measured between the drain and the gate terminal. And in this way, the gate terminal is common between the input and the output side. And therefore, this configuration is known as the common gate amplifier configuration. Now, unlike the other MOSFET amplifier configurations, here in this configuration, the input impedance of the amplifier is low. Now, normally, we say that the input impedance of the amplifier should be as high as possible, right? Because in that case, the maximum applied input signal will appear across the input of the amplifier. But in some high frequency applications, this type of common gate amplifier is very useful. So in such application, the output of the antenna or the transmission line is given to the amplifier for the amplification. So in such application, the input impedance of the amplifier should match with the characteristic impedance of the antenna. And the impedance of this antenna or the transmission line is typically in the ohms. And in such case, this common gate amplifier is suitable for the impedance matching. So through a small signal analysis, we will find the expression of the input and the output impedance as well as the voltage gain for this common gate amplifier. So first of all, we will start with very basic common gate amplifier circuit, and gradually we will see the actual circuit of the common gate amplifier. So this is a very basic circuit for the common gate amplifier along with the biasing. So as you can see, here the gate is biased with the fixed voltage, and here the AC input signal is applied at the source terminal, while the output is measured at the drain terminal. So for the DC analysis, this AC input signal will act as a zero. And this is the biasing circuit for the common gate amplifier. Now this biasing voltage and this drain resistor should be such that the MOSFET operates in the saturation region. Alright, so if we talk about the small signal analysis, then for the AC analysis, this biasing voltage will act as a zero. And also, this capacitor will act as a short circuit. Moreover, this drain voltage VDD will also act as a zero. And then after, we need to replace this MOSFET by the small signal model. So here, throughout the video, for a simplicity, we are assuming that the MOSFET is operating at relatively low frequencies, where this small signal model of the MOSFET is valid. So for this small signal analysis, if you see, the input is appearing between the source and the ground terminal. And here, this gate terminal is grounded. Also, if you see over here, then this drain resistor RD is appearing between the drain and the ground terminal. And if you see the small signal equivalent circuit, then it will look like this. So for this very basic common gate amplifier, let us find the input impedance, output impedance and the voltage gain. And first, let us start with the input impedance. So as we have seen earlier, if Vin is the input signal and Iin is the input current, then the ratio of this input signal to the input current will give us the input impedance. So if we apply the KCL at this node, then we can write this input current plus drain current ID is equal to zero. Or we can say that this input current is equal to minus ID, where this drain current ID is equal to minus GM times VGS. Now, if you observe over here, then this input signal is appearing between the source and the ground terminal. And since the gate terminal is at AC ground, so we can say that the input is appearing between the source and the gate terminal. Or we can say that this voltage VGS is equal to minus VI. So from this, we can say that this input current IN, which was minus GM times VGS, can also be given as GM times VIN. That means the ratio of this input voltage to the input current or the input impedance is equal to 1 divided by GM. And this 1 over GM is typically in the ohms. So as you can see, for this common gate amplifier, the input impedance is lower compared to other configurations, because in other configurations, the input impedance is in mega ohms. Alright, so similarly, now let us find the output impedance. So the output impedance is the Thevenin's equivalent impedance which is seen from the output side by considering all the independent sources in the circuit as zero. That means while finding this output impedance, we will consider this input signal as zero. So now if you see, then this gate and the source terminal both are at the same potential. That means this voltage VGS will be zero. And since the voltage VGS is zero, then this drain current ID will also become zero. Or we can say that this dependent current source will act as an open circuit. That means now the Thevenin's equivalent impedance, which is seen from the output side, or this output impedance, is equal to RD. So that is the output impedance of this very basic common gate amplifier. And similarly, now let us find the voltage gain. So here, to find the voltage gain, let us apply the KCL at this node. So let's say the current through this resistor RD is equal to I0, and this current is equal to ID. That means after applying the KCL, we can write this output current plus ID is equal to 0. And here, this output current is equal to V0 divided by RD. That means V0 divided by RD is equal to minus ID. And this drain current is equal to GM times VGS. Now, as we have just seen, this VGS is equal to minus VI, right? That means we can say that Vout divided by RD is equal to minus GM times minus VI. Or we can say that this Vout divided by VI is equal to GM times RD. So that is the voltage gain of this common gate amplifier. So if you observe this expression, then we can say that the voltage gain of this common gate amplifier is similar to the common source amplifier. But here there is a no-negative sign, meaning that in this common gate amplifier, the input and the output signal will be in the same phase. Alright, so far through this very basic common gate amplifier, we found that its input impedance is very low, while the output impedance and the voltage gain is same as the common source amplifier. But here in the voltage gain, there is a no negative sign. That means the input and output are in the same phase. So far we have assumed that a separate biasing voltage was applied at the gate terminal. But that can also be applied through the voltage divider bias. And here, this capacitor is connected between the gate and the ground terminal. So for the DC analysis, this capacitor will act as an open circuit. But for the small signal analysis or for the AC analysis, this capacitor will act as a short circuit. And this voltage VDD will also become zero. That means now, both ends of this R1 and R2 are connected to the AC ground. And therefore, this gate is connected to the AC ground. Now typically, the input signal to the amplifier may be coming from output of some other amplifier stage. So to isolate the biasing circuits of the amplifiers, and just for coupling the AC input signal to the next stage, the input is typically applied through the coupling capacitor. But if we apply the input in this fashion, then at the DC, the coupling capacitor will act as an open circuit. That means now, there is no path for the drain current to flow through the source terminal. Similarly, when the input is coming from some antenna, then at the DC, the antenna will act as an open circuit. And once again, there is no path for drain current to flow through the source terminal. That means to complete the biasing path, usually a source resistor is connected between the source and the ground terminal, so that at the DC, the drain current can flow through this source resistor. So at the DC, if you observe this circuit, then it is the voltage divider biasing circuit which you have discussed earlier, right? But here, now the input is applied at the source terminal. Alright, so for this actual circuit, now let us find the three important parameters, that is input impedance, output impedance and the voltage gain. And let us also see what is the impact of this source resistor on these three parameters. So for the AC analysis, all the capacitors will act as a short circuit at the operating frequency, and this DC voltage source will also act as a zero. and then after, if we replace the MOSFET by the small signal model, then the equivalent circuit will look like this. And first of all, now let us find the input impedance. So as we have seen, without this source resistor, the equivalent impedance which is seen from the input side is equal to 1 over GM, right? That means from the input side, if we see the equivalent circuit, then it will look like this. That means now, the input impedance which is seen from the input side is the parallel combination of this RS and the 1 over GM. That means the input impedance is equal to 1 over GM in parallel with RS. But still, if you are not convinced, then let us apply the KCL at this node. And applying the KCL, we can get the same result. So as we have seen, this input impedance is the ratio of the input signal to the input current. So here, this will be the input current. And the current through the source resistor is equal to Vin divided by RS. So applying the KCL at this node, we can write this input current plus drain current is equal to Vin divided by RS. That is this current. And this drain current ID is equal to GM times VGS. And as we have seen, this VGS is equal to minus Vin. That means Iin plus GM times VGS is equal to Vin divided by RS. Or if we further simplify it, then we can say that this input current is equal to Vin divided by RS plus GM times Vin. Because here, this VGS is equal to minus Vin. So if we further simplify it, then we can say that this input current is equal to Vin times GM plus 1 divided by RS. That means input current to the input voltage or 1 divided by Zin is equal to GM plus 1 divided by RS. Or we can say that it is equal to 1 divided by RS plus 1 divided by 1 over GM. That means this input impedance is the parallel combination of 1 over GM and RS. So that is the input impedance of the amplifier. Now if the value of RS is much greater than 1 over GM, or let's say at least 10 times more than 1 over GM, then this input impedance is approximately equal to 1 over GM. But if this RS and 1 over GM are comparable, then the input impedance will be less than 1 over GM. Alright, so similarly, now let us find the output impedance. And let us find out, is there any impact of the source resistor on the output impedance? So as we have seen, the output impedance is the Thevenin's equivalent impedance which is seen from the output side by considering all the independent sources in the circuit as 0. So to find the output impedance, we will consider this input signal as 0. And since the input signal will act as a 0, then this source resistor will also act as a short circuit. And now, the gate and the source both are at the same potential. That means VGS is equal to 0. And since the VGS is 0, then this drain current ID will also become 0. That means this dependent current source will act as an open circuit. And in this case, the output impedance or the Thevenin's equivalent impedance which is seen from the output side is equal to RD. That means the source resistor will not have any impact on the output impedance. Alright, so similarly, now let us find the voltage gain. So if you see over here, then the voltage gain will remain the same. Because here, if we apply the KCL at this node, then we can write I0 plus ID that is equal to 0. That means V0 divided by RD plus GM times VGS that is equal to 0. And since the VGS is equal to minus VI, so we can say that Vout divided by RD that is equal to GM times Vin, or V0 divided by Vin, or the voltage gain is equal to GM times RD. That means the voltage gain will remain the same. But that is only true if the internal impedance of this voltage source is 0. Practically, all the source has some finite internal impedance. Let's say this internal impedance is equal to Ri. And if that is the case, then this internal resistance will have the impact on the voltage gain. So in that case, the voltage at this node will not be equal to Vin. And in fact, because of the voltage drop across this resistor, the voltage at this node will be less than Vin. So let's say the voltage at this node is equal to Vx. So now the overall voltage gain, that is Vout divided by Vin, can be given as Vout divided by Vx times Vx divided by Vin. So the ratio of this Vout divided by Vx will be equal to Gm times Rd, because the voltage gain is the ratio of the output voltage to the input which is appearing between the source and the gate terminal. So the only thing which we need to find over here is the ratio of the Vx and the Vin, and that can be easily found if we replace the entire circuit which is seen on the right hand side of this node. And in fact, it is the input impedance of this amplifier. So if we replace this entire circuit by the input impedance of the amplifier, then the equivalent circuit will look like this. That means now the voltage at this node, or the Vx, can be given as Zi divided by Zi plus Ri times input signal. That is equal to 1 over Gm in parallel with Rs divided by 1 over Gm in parallel with Rs plus Ri times input signal. That means now the overall voltage gain, that is Vout divided by Vin, will be equal to Vout divided by Vx times Vx divided by Vin. That is equal to Gm times Rd times 1 over Gm in parallel with Rs divided by 1 over Gm in parallel with Rs plus Ri. So that is the overall voltage gain if we also consider the effect of the internal resistance of this input signal. So if this Ri is much lower than the input impedance, then the voltage gain is approximately equal to Gm times Rd. But if this Ri is comparable to the input impedance, then the voltage gain will reduce. So that is the voltage gain of this common gate amplifier, including the series resistor of this input source. And here, if the load resistor RL is also connected, then instead of Rd, we will have a Rd parallel RL. So in this way, using the small signal analysis, we found the expression of the voltage gain, the input impedance and the output impedance of this common gate amplifier. So on the second channel, we will see few examples on this common gate amplifier, and we will understand a few design aspects of this amplifier. But I hope in this video, you understood how to do the small signal analysis of this common gate amplifier, and using that, how we can find the different amplifier parameters. So if you have any question or suggestion, then do let me know here in the comment section below. If you like this video, hit the like button and subscribe to the channel for more such videos.